Hello, my name is Henry Hunter, and today in this video I will be demonstrating to you the functionalities of the PORTASTEELE calculator. The PORTASTEELE calculator is used as a supporting device for our Portalevel range. So once you've taken non-invasively taken an accurate liquid level measurement with the Portalevel Max or any other product in our Portalevel range, you can then use the PORTASTEELE to calculate the agent mass. Now this is very important because most regulations state that you need to identify the agent mass using a listed device. So here we have the opening screen of the PORTASTEELE calculator. On the top you've got the calculator, which is the basic function, and you've got the database that allows you to take readings, store them, which would help with reporting and general ease of use. So we'll open up calculator. Right, now this is the main interface. So on the top we have the agents that can be calculated currently using the PORTASTEELE, being CO2, NOVEC and FM200. We are currently in the process of updating this with more agents, predominantly in the HFC family. And we can also update your PORTASTEELE with the latest changes retrospectively using our remote capabilities. On the right we have the units. So at the moment it's set to metric, but you have the means to change it to imperial. This is quite useful, especially to those in America who stubbornly continue to use imperial, which we're happy to support them with. And at the bottom we have two methods. So the first is calculating the agent mass from the liquid level. We can also reverse that to calculate where the liquid level should be if the cylinder is correctly filled and there's been no leak or discharge. So that can be useful to an engineer who wants to make sure that his liquid level measurement is compliant with what it should be. And then we have our range of inputs, the first being height, circumference, liquid level, temperature, dome height and thickness. So now I've taken a liquid level measurement using the Portalevel Max on a fairly standard 45 kilo CO2 cylinder that you might find in the marine industry and indeed land-based. So the height, we take the height from the base of the cylinder to the shoulder, and the shoulder is the part of the cylinder where it, at the top where it's where it's still straight, and then when it starts curving that's too far. So when you're taking a measure, you want it from the base of the cylinder to the top of the straight part of the cylinder. So in this case, it's 137 centimetres. The next very important input is circumference. Now, this is probably one of the most influential variables, and it's important that you get this right. So I recommend that you use like a soft tape measure, like a Taylor tape measure, for a more accurate measurement. So in this case, it's 84.5. The liquid level, again taken from the base of the cylinder, to your liquid level. Now the modern Portalevel sensors have a marking on the side of the sensor, and that's where you should take the measurement from. So in this instance it's 104 centimeters. Temperature, it's a balmy March day at 17 degrees. Dome height, 9. Thickness. Now if you don't have a thickness gauge or you don't know the thickness, don't worry, because it's the least influential input. And I would recommend that you put in 6 mil, which is probably the industry average for fire suppression cylinders. But in this instance, I've used a PORTAGAUGE 3 to identify the wall thickness, and it is 7 mil. So now I'll calculate. So it's equated 45.6 kilos for a 45 kilo CO2 cylinder. So that's good, that's spot on the money. That's reassuring that the cylinder hasn't leaked, and provided in the industry standards is 5%. So in this instance, if we had 42.5 or lower, then it would be recommended that that cylinder is taken out to be refilled. I will now demonstrate the second part of the calculator, which is the data logging function. So we'd get out of calculator and we'll go into database. This is where we would upload a cylinder. So here we have an example, and then we've also got one that I've done earlier. So this is a cylinder that I've put the inputs that we just did, and I can use this to help with my ease of use. So because I've already stored the dimension data of that cylinder, I just need to put in the liquid level and the temperature. So let's say if I put in 85 centimeters, same temperature, 17 degrees, and it would calculate 41. So this lower liquid level has equated 41 kilos of agent, which would indicate to us that cylinder needs to be removed to be weighed and refilled. Equally, if I put in 102, then it calculates just over at 46.5. And we can add this result to our records. And it's added to our records. And so we can compile a report from that, which is, you know, useful data that you can then data log and relay to whoever you want. Thank you very much for listening to this video. If you have any questions, please follow the links below. And we look forward to talking with you. Thank you very much.